My makeup thing, and I once again have embarrassed myself for my friend Vin. Okay, I'm doing this video for Vin because she was brave enough for her try something Tuesday or something. She's got all those fancy names, but. Anyway, she did her morning makeup routine and then said that challenged us to do the same. And I liked hers because hers looks as goofy as mine does. And I happen to like makeup a lot. When I was working in a factory or around men, I did not wear makeup, which makes me look totally different. When I worked with the public, I wore makeup and did my hair every day. And then when I did, I kept cutting my hair shorter and shorter because then it took less and less time to do my hair. Because doing your hair is a pain in the ass. Which is why I like clips. But I lost my clips, so right now I have a black clip in my hair because I just got out of the shower because my hair was in no way ready to be filmed. So. And it's 11:17 at night. So really, this is my, I don't really have a morning routine. So this would be my, oh God, I gotta wear makeup routine. And I'll do the one that I use if I know I'm gonna be doing a lot of videos or Steam It. Because that really, up until Steam It, I couldn't count on two hands the amount of times I put makeup on over since I stopped working. One of the things I will say is that if you have a cold and you're older, or even if you aren't older, but you have a cold, plain Pond's, which is dry skin cream, you know when you get a cold and your nose is all red? This stuff is golden. I don't think it's that expensive because my husband has never complained about it. And I bathe in it on my face and my nose doesn't get red and I love it. And that's my secret is 1948 Pond's. Nothing anti-aging, nothing, just Pond's cream. Okay, so then I have this little basket. And it's in a basket because I go to my mom's a lot. Because she's down in Florida. And then I'm too lazy to take it out of the basket when I get home. So it just actually kind of migrated to the basket. Now, I will say, when I was working, I used to go get my eyebrows waxed, and best thing ever, because it hurts to do the plucking of the eyebrows, and so I don't, because I cry, and it hurts. So, to go pay to have somebody rip it off is what I would do. But now, I can't afford to do that, so hence bangs come in really handy. So that's a secret. So what I do if, because I just took a shower. So what I do, and I'm running out of makeup because I've been doing so many videos on Steam It, is I got this at like Walmart, I don't know, a while ago. And it's almost empty, so I'm going to have to get some more. And it's a liquid True Match. I don't know what that means. Something. But it's a cover-up. And I need that because right now, normally on really, really bad days, my dark circles will literally go down to here. They'll be black. And, well, I don't mind. When I'm by myself, I don't think it's quite, I want to say the word attractive, but you know, I mean, if you want to watch somebody with really dark circles under their eyes, you probably don't. So, I use this, and quite honestly, I've never used this before until I got it, and then I used it, I think, very wrong, and I think I still do, but it works. So what I do is, and I've never done this quite like this before, I mush it all over like this, and I think I use way too much, but you know what? It covers what I want it to cover. So I do that, and then put this back on, but it's running out. And then I smear it everywhere, because as you get older, you get these like weird things that pop up on your skin, and you're like, when did that happen? And now I look like a ghost, which I think is hilarious, because I've never quite done this like this, you know. So I could end up looking kind of scary when we're done here. So, and then I started getting this red spot right here. And I never had that before. And I'm still sweating. There's a fan going and everything. That's what happens when you take a shower at 11 o'clock at night. So I just use my hands. And somewhere upstairs, I'm sure I have primer. Because I was addicted to makeup from QVC for a while. So I'm sure one of the packets came with some kind of primer. But I don't use it. I mean, I don't know. I guess you're supposed to, but. But because of that, I have really cool brushes. Because of getting makeup from QVC, because their kits that I bought always came with a brush. And actually, the powder that I use is from the last kit, which is like 2 years old, but it's going fast now because of Steam It, is Laura Geller. And I like her stuff, so I'm going to have to keep my eye out, because it was like $30 and you got like 8 things that I use every day. Well, not every day, when I have to put makeup on. But I'm running out of the powder stuff. But if you go to the store and buy it at Sephora, which would be the closest one to me, it's like $50. Well, I don't have $50, and I'm not spending $50 on makeup. So, anyway, so I take this. Well, I always start with my eyes because they're the worst. And I just take my big brush and mush it all over my face. And I go down my neck and my chin. And then, and the worst thing with white hair is, number one, if you use liquid makeup with white hair, it gets stuck in your hair. So then, you have these streaks of colored makeup in your hair, which is not really attractive. So, one of the reasons I don't like liquid makeup. Now, if I could actually see what's going on. So, anyway, and I just try to, you know, so that it looks even. Okay. So that's the foundation that I use. So let's put that over there. Then, this thing that I got from Laura Geller, that was like $30, came with this really nice blush also. And this is another old brush that I had from, I don't know, some kit. But I really like this because it's not pink. And when you have white hair, you actually have to wear, well, number one, different color than you're used to, unless you have blonde hair, maybe. But you actually have to wear more makeup because you look like a ghost. So when I first let my hair go all the way white and stopped looking like a skunk, And I know this is like really heavy, and I probably wouldn't like do it this heavy if I was upstairs. But it's really hard to see, and I don't have my glasses on either. So you need, when you have white hair, you end up looking like a ghost. I had to go out and learn and get different colors, deeper colors than I was used to. So that's rule number one when you have white hair, is go somewhere and have them help you or try on other colors than you normally would wear, because what used to work for you, yes, it'll still work, but you look not as good as you would if you got colors that are for white hair, which are brighter colors. So then I also see this kit was like, and I'm gonna cry when it's gone, and I'm using it because of steam it. So this came with like all these brown colors, which I love. So I used this one here, and then I just see, but you don't want to move your bangs too much, because then you can't, then they'll stay that way, and I'll mind. My hair only likes to do one thing, and then it's got to stay there and like set. And if it doesn't, then it does whatever it wants. My hair also, and then see, if I had like really nice eyebrows, you take the white and you put it right up here. And this is if you're getting really fancy. And then I just take the brown here, and then I go in the crease here. And it always makes me think of Cher. Because, well, back in the day, that's how she did hers. And Barbara Streisand. And both of those ladies had very cool makeup. Well, and I almost wrote a letter to Cher once asking if I could have one of her hats. She used to wear these really cool hats. So, anyway. And then I think I'm being way more picky than I normally am. So that's that. And then I have this really crappy mascara. Now, if I ever go to Walmart and have money and think about it at the same time, that's on my list. What I need to do is write a list of what I need. So this is like, I don't even know what it is, because it's just a black tube. But it's crap. Now, one of the things I did learn from watching, I don't know, something, because I do like makeup, and this is going to be really hard to do, is if you do the top, holy crap, this is really hard. I guess it's a good thing you can't see me that close, but between the whole glasses thing and being far away, poke myself in the eye. I didn't see me cry. So if you do your top lashes first, then the bottom lashes, the top lashes will dry and it won't leave specks of mascara on your eyelids. And I was like, ha! That makes freaking sense. But I don't always remember that. But if you do remember, see, this is getting old too. I think I might have got some in my eye. And I really can't see what I'm doing. So I'm just hoping I'm getting close. To my lashes, and it's not all over my actual skin. Okay, so I have a big blobby there. Okay, so that's that. Now my eyes are burning, so, and normally they don't, But either way, oh, this is L'Oreal. I don't know what kind of L'Oreal. I don't remember. It sucks. It also burned your eyes. So then, I'm sweating. So then, what I do is wish that my eyebrows look better every time I do makeup. Then, years ago, and as Ben said, you're not supposed to use really old makeup ever because it'll cause, I don't know, but you to die. Horrible, painful death. And you'll never see again. So don't ever use two-year-old makeup. Okay, I'd have to look at that later. So then I have these old that I smash box things that I got in another kit years ago. And I like them because they're waterproof. And again, I never went to Sephora, which is why I always have a sticker shock. Because and I'm not telling you to go to QVC, or I've never bought anything from HSN, so I don't know. So I'm just saying that it's where I got all my brushes over the years. And all my cool makeup that is now really old, but I like. So you just stick this in here, and it's like kind of like a pasty thing. I don't even know if they make this anymore, so I'm very careful about that. And then what I do, I'm like clicking on my corner, closing my eye, and swipe it back and forth. Normally, I can actually see if it did anything. But here, it's kind of hard to tell. And I think it did, but I don't know. So, then I do the other one. Oh. And then I usually add a little up there. Okay, and I keep playing with my bangs because, like I said, if they go off to the side, and right now they're kind of wet because I'm hot, and if they dry off to the side, I'm screwed. That's where they're staying. So that is pretty much it when it comes to makeup. If I'm gonna do a video, the big thing would be, I need more of this because I love this. The Smashbox used to have one too that would like turn, but I don't think they make that anymore. That's actually where this brush came from. I don't think they make that anymore. Now, this is really the secret for me, is the under eye thing. So it covers and some days my dark circles are literally black, and I can feel good, but they're really black. So this is a lifesaver, and I need some more of this. Now, also, like Ben, I don't like lipstick, and I went to Sephora at our JCPenney's. And the one that I liked was, I think I said it was like $30 or something. Yeah, I'm not spending $30 for lipstick or lip gloss. It's just not going to happen. So I have this one that I've probably had like 10 years. Tells you how much I wear lip gloss. But if I'm going to be doing a video, then I just put this on it. And I just set my face. Okay. It smells good too. And you don't need a lot. It's nice. Oh, my lips are dry. But I don't really think that lipsticks like that actually help your lips. So, I don't really think I look that much different. But we'll see. One of the other things that, if I'm gonna like really be doing videos, not in real life, I mean not like walking out the door, but if I'm gonna be doing videos, I got this years ago, and it's from Bare Minerals, and it is called Flawless Radiation. This stuff is cool because somehow it's like glowy, but you don't see it. Oh, I'm sweating. And so you just swirl it in the doohickey. And holy shit. Okay, it's usually not that much that comes out. Or maybe it is, but by the time I get downstairs I've gotten rid of most of it. I don't know. Well, now I look like I'm glowing. Okay, I definitely used way too much. Because that's a little too glowy for me. Okay, so it really doesn't look like I have blush on. Maybe it's just, I'm gonna look like a clown is what I'm gonna look like when I actually see this someplace else with another brush. So really, that's all I do. It's really not much. The big thing is hiding the dark circles under my eyes. I personally now don't like to wear makeup, so all that is in my. And then when I travel, it has a lid, and then I go down by my mom's, and then she thinks that I'm gonna actually put this stuff on when it's 120 degrees outside, and really humid, and then I don't put any of it on, but I bring it, just in case. I feel like sweating and having makeup run down my face. I don't know. But anyway, I bring it every time, just in case. Because you never know when you're going to need makeup. Which actually, now that Hots and Shots, I will look probably a lot like this. Except if we do it outside, you will see like streaks of sweat running down my face. So then we'll take, it's one of those clips. Because I lost my clip, but actually it broke. If this was my last hair clip, it broke. And my head is like really sensitive. So I don't like a lot of hair clips. So I'm really actually very upset about this hair clip because I need a new one because having my hair down all the time drives me nuts. So, Ben also asked about my hair, and basically I wash it and blow, well, it depends. If I'm going to do something with it, I need to wash it, blow dry it, straight iron it, and then hairspray the shit out of it. And make sure that my bangs are straight. Or down. Because I look really dumb without bangs. If I'm not going anywhere and I'm showering, I will just dry my hair and not do anything with it. And then it doesn't matter. I will, 3 hours later, my mom will call on Skype, and I will look like a homeless person with my hair. So my hair, it actually needs to be done in order to look decent, which is why I love clips. So normally, then I will do all this wonderful stuff, and then take my clip that I don't have anymore, and then I just shove it all in there, and then that's it. But that clip doesn't hurt, where this one kind of does. So really, it's all about the bangs, which, quite honestly, they need to be. Well, I keep pulling on them, but they need to be cut. But I need a haircut, but I don't want to go get a haircut. So I just hack up my own bangs when they bother me. And that's it. That's my makeup thing. And I once again have embarrassed myself for my friend, Vin. Yeah.